Hi, and welcome to this edition of BCPS News. I'm Mary Beth Marsden. On today's show, we'll check out an elementary school that has earned national recognition, some sea creatures in the classroom, and a student author. All this and more, but first, let's check out what's trending. Tech and Learning magazine has selected Della Curtis, BCPS's Coordinator of Library Services, as one of three national winners in its 24th annual Leader of the Year program. The award recognizes visionaries who exemplify extraordinary education technology leadership, often working within budgetary restrictions and limited resources. Curtis has served as head of BCPS's Library Information Services since 1981 and spearheaded the school system's first website, a partnership with Towson University, and improved teacher, student, and family access to school library information resources, just to name a few. Maryland has gained 241 new nationally board-certified teachers for 2011. Considered as instructional superstars, the state ranks 11th in the nation, with BCPS ranking as one of the top five school districts in the state. The certification is a voluntary program and typically takes more than a year to complete. BCPS has a total of 114 national board-certified teachers in the system. A group of students at Winand Elementary School are having so much fun. Once a week, the So Fun Sewing Club meets to do a little stitching. Under the direction of instructor Margaret Garland, they are learning the skills of using a sewing machine, creating wearable items, and most importantly, learning to give back. The girls are working on a charity project called Make It, Give It, where they are creating hats and scarves and gloves that will be given to those in need at a local homeless shelter. The after-school sewing club started 3 years ago. Stay with us. There's more to come.
Savings Man here with a story for you about two young spenders named Tommy and Sue. Their parents let them buy whatever they chose, like video games and designer clothes. As they grew older, they spent all their pay on fancy cars, houses, two lattes a day. They lived in the moment, never saving a dime. When they tried to retire, they'd run out of time. Working forever is Tom and Sue's fate, so choose to save now before it's too late. Visit our website to find out more, because a happy ending's worth saving for.
Welcome back. For the third year in a row, a Baltimore County school receives a national honor. Let's head down the hallways and into the classrooms to see what their formula for success is all about.
Sandalwood Elementary School, located in Essex, recently earned a nationwide honor when it was named a national Title I Distinguished School for 2011-2012.
It's really a great thing. The teachers here work very long hours. They work before school, after school with our kids. They give up their planning weekly to analyze data. They even have working lunches with the students. So it's really a well-deserved recognition for them.
Title I is a federally funded grant program designed to provide supplemental resources to schools in economically disadvantaged areas. Students at these schools often face social and environmental challenges in addition to the economic issues.
We have come from some real challenges behaviorally and academically, and the team has just continued to persevere and work through them as a team, accomplishing as much as we can, and to finally be recognized in our little haven down here. It's a wonderful experience for all. I'm very proud of our staff.
While the school receives additional resources through Title I, it is the shared sense of responsibility among the faculty and staff that has allowed the school to achieve positive results.
There is such a sense of team around here, starting in the primary grades, going all the way up to the intermediate. The teachers here just really go above and beyond. And even the specials teachers, they give up some of their time during planning to do lunch bunches with kids. The gym teacher pulls small groups to do math intervention. Like, that is just something that isn't a norm in all schools.
Everyone feels like these are our students. And I think that if you have that sense of commitment to each other and not just your tasks, it makes such a difference. It makes coming to work a joy every day.
In my classroom, we have two other adults and then me. So we're able to do the three groups, which really helps us meet the needs of the students. And it's just been great. These past 3 years, I've been able to see the collaboration not only within my own classroom, but amongst all the teachers. We all work together and able to come up with the best strategies to use with our children.
These teachers love their kids and are willing to do what it takes. It's a wonderful thing. I ask, they say yes every time. And it makes this working here for me a distinct pleasure.
You're doing a great job.
2 years ago, Chadwick Elementary received the National Distinguished Title I School designation, and last year, Millbrook Elementary received the honor. And by the way, the principal of Sandalwood, Philip Byers, and the principal of Millbrook, Christina Byers, are husband and wife. Quite a winning team. Now, got ink? Prepare your pens because the students at Pinewood Elementary sure do.
Well, we're all familiar with our good friend Squidward. Well, here's something you can stick your tentacles on. The students at Pinewood Elementary School take a closer look at this guy from the inside out.
You're going to use your fingers and one of you will gently kind of puff it up so it forms a pocket. You can take your scissors and cut from one end all the way down to the arrow end.
Our young biologists were aided by the National Aquarium's own Christina Ramona and David Christopher. With their help, this slippery situation turned out to be both an enjoyable and informative activity.
What was your first impression of the squid when you saw it, when they took it out the bucket and plopped it right here on your newspaper? How did you
feel? It was cool, but disgusting. I think it was pretty cool because I've only dissected a worm before. So.
So is this your first time, Jenna, dissecting something?
Yes.
And how do you like dissecting things?
Yeah, it's pretty cool because learning more about the animal.
That's great.
There weren't any writing assignments due, but there was certainly a lot of ink involved in this lesson.
What have you learned so far?
Well,
that it has the siphon and it breathes in and out from it.
Wow, good vocabulary.
And also it has the beak, which has two parts.
For BCPS News, Squidly.
Diddly!
I'm Jessica Dorch.
The National Aquarium Squid Dissection Lab is just one of many educational outreach programs available for local schools. Find out more at aqua.org. Coming up next, we are going around the county to take flight with water. Let's see how this wet experiment turns out.
Ready? 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Students at Essex Elementary blast off to new heights with their model water rockets as part of the fourth grade pilot project as an extension of the Star Lab Portable Planetarium program.
They've been studying space all week in the Star Lab. They built their water rockets last week in teams of four. There were 23 rocket teams, and then we launched them.
I watched rockets fly in the air, including mine.
The students were eager to be able to assemble their rockets on their own.
We had to cut out a cone top, make our rocket by putting tape and having a big 2-liter bottle and putting it all together.
The exciting launches were experienced through hands-on work and observation.
They collected data. They did some math. They had some math. They had to do averaging. They had to use a protractor to use their homemade clinometers to calculate the altitude of each rocket that went into the sky today.
The students made it their priority to beat the record for the highest water rocket launch that was set by Robert Goddard.
So their goal was to beat his record, and most of them did that today with their water rockets.
Did you know?
Have you ever thought about writing a book? Well, for one BCPS high school student, she's already become a published author. Let's get in focus to see how the story unfolds.
I love writing.
because it allows you to go out of your world.
Okay, class, let's take your books out.
English is the subject Perry Hall student Anna Denish loves the most. That's because she's a published author.
I had a figurine for my grandmother, and it was the clown. And one night I was cleaning my room, and I was reading The Nutcracker. And I thought, how cool would it be if this could actually happen? And I found the figurine, and it just kind of fell into place.
Tate Publishing thought so much of the book, they decided to publish it.
We were in Barnes & Noble's, and my mom got a call, and she had to go outside. And I was like, okay, I'll wait. And she came back in, and she was like, Anna, it was the publisher that kind of published. And we just kind of like had a little mini freak-out party in Barnes & Noble's, and I was just very excited because it was the first step to making my dream come true.
And I always knew she could come up with these ideas, but when she finished it, it was quite an accomplishment.
Come on, Mary, what's taking so long? Casey asked as she waited.
The book is about a clown figurine named Jack, who comes to life and takes Mary into his world.
I think that Jack the Clown, he's a very likable character, especially coming from someone who doesn't really like clowns so much.
The book is doing well and can be found on both Barnes & Noble and Amazon websites. So what's next for Anna?
I plan to go to college for creative writing, and I hope to finish publishing the rest of this series and any others that come up with it, and eventually start publishing novels and just publish as much as I can.
With such lofty goals, sometimes you just need some encouragement from someone close to you to achieve them.
Never told me I couldn't do it. She never said, I don't think it's going to happen. She was always, you can do it. And to have someone like that who you're so close with, who just supports you, it really helps, because sometimes you can feel like you're alone, but when you have your mom or a best friend there, it's really just, it helps.
He had white powder all over his face.
This first book will not be the last book for Anna or Jack the Clown.
Anna certainly has a lot more writing to do and a bright future ahead of her. That does it for this edition of BCPS News. If you have any story ideas, comments, or suggestions, contact us at edchannel@bcps.org and follow BCPS on Facebook and Twitter. As we leave you today, a change of season is in the air. Let's take a look at some of the sights and sounds of the holiday. Until next time, I'm Mary Beth Marsden. Have a wonderful and safe holiday break. And thanks for watching.
Diversification. It's a pretty big word, especially when it comes to structuring your investment portfolio. Simply put, don't put all your eggs in one basket. Learn more about the importance of diversifying your portfolio and choose to save.
There's no such thing as a small distraction. A public service reminder from the American Academy of Orthopedic Surgeons. Speak out against distracted driving at decidetodrive.org.